coffee drinkers, what's happening? I don't know why I'm like, I'm kind of psyched today. There's nothing specific or special going on, but feel really good. I'm not going to question that. Maybe it's because I'm here. That's always nice. The day is starting out as it often does with a pretty solid workout. I'm about to go in the gym over here and then go up there and get on the court with Jimmy V and do a little battling. He's been gone, I've been gone. We haven't played tennis in a while, so this is going to be a fun one. This is the calm before the storm.
It's not a sanctioned match. It's a friendly hit.
A friendly hit, let's see.
I'm just coming off the injured list. It's too windy.
Too windy, injured list. Let's rack up these excuses before we start. Haven't hit a single ball yet.
Anymore? Sitting in traffic.
Hours. Wow. 11. All right, so we're 2 hours into the match. We split sets. He got me 7-5 in the first. I got him 6-5 in the second. He's on a little bathroom break. It's 5 o'clock, going way longer than I thought I was gonna go today, but it's worth it going the distance, three sets. See if I can keep it together mentally long enough to pull off this third set, or at least keep it close. 11-9 in the buster. Let's get a close up of that, shall we?
Great match. Great match.
Yeah, great for him. Because he won 11-9. So I'm back working on sounds today. Having started out the day feeling really good, I actually feel pretty shitty right now. I don't know why. It wasn't because of the loss in the tennis, although that did teach me a lot of things about myself. Losses are going to happen, wins are going to happen. It's, you know, not a big deal. But I can't put my finger on it. I really don't know what it is. I do not feel great right now. I think that has something to do with not feeling home. I think that's been on my mind a little bit too much recently. And I just don't feel like I'm home right now. Even though I'm like in my home, right now with my amps and my bass and everything and the pedals and all kinds of crazy stuff. I really don't feel like I'm home yet. I'm not sure if I've ever felt like I was home. Maybe that's the thing. And I think I start to think about the time and about the hours and about doing the work and what that actually means. And I think that's probably the only time I do feel kind of some semblance of home is when I'm doing the work or when I'm traveling or on stage playing for audiences or just practicing, you know, simple stuff at home or getting lost inside a bunch of pedals and stuff. I'm waving this Moogerfooger around. I am going to plug it in. Don't worry. We're going to, at least I hope I'm going to get some sounds out of it. I have this kind of a shka kind of sound in mind. This is what I'm trying to create. I'm trying to create a really big ambient sounding, not a backbeat. I don't know whether it's a snare drum, but it's some kind of ska, like upper mid range, sort of in the snare drum family kind of sound, but with a ska, with a kind of an initial attack, which I hope I'm going to get from this Freq Box. And then I got to figure out my delays and my reverbs after the fact. I'm really considering this Earthquaker device's Arpanoid and a couple of their delay reverb combinations, and then there's a Dwarcraft pitch something or the other. I've been kind of geeking out about pedals lately. But the is the sound I'm looking for today. Hopefully I'll get it and that will cheer me up a little bit. That would be kind of nice, huh? But of course, it needs its own power supply, which is kind of a drag. I hope I don't get the sound and then fall in love with it and want to take it on the road because the pedal is huge and the power supply is a pain in the ass to carry around. But I think also part of the problem is today that I think after 20 years of practicing in apartments and having to deal with neighbors and not being able to just be like, okay, it's 3 a.m. and I want to go, you know, I think that might finally be getting to me. I think I might consider sacrificing a lot of things just to have space to create music in and to practice in and to make noise whenever I want and not be on anybody else's schedule or anything, basically. Just have kind of the freedom. I think after 20 years, maybe I earned it. Who knows? Now the question is, can I actually pull it off and find a place? Hopefully that doesn't mean like moving to the middle of nowhere, living in North Dakota or something. Hopefully I can do that like right up the street from where I live now. But I think those are the kind of things that are going on today in my brain that are not particularly easy to deal with. I will say that. But I guess out of that is kind of the hope and looking to the future, to the near future, I hope, to try and resolve that. It's just the kind of a series of problems and trying to find solutions for them, I think. I mean, maybe my whole life has been a little bit like that. So this should just be yet another problem, and I'll find a solution because I always do. Yeah, God, man, not every day is a good one. Maybe that's what I take out of today. And not every day has to be good. Maybe you need some bad days like this to kind of kick you in the ass to figuring it all out, you know, or not even all of it, but figuring out the thing that might be on your mind. So that's what's going on in my mind today. Let's try and get to the pedals and do something productive. I might need a bass for that. Okay, definitely can't be playing that loud. Okay, we got some reverb happening. Let's see. Pretty big. Now let's see. Okay. Let's turn the output level down a little bit on that. Maybe get a square waveform. I wonder. Now I gotta figure out, like, there's probably a pedal that does this. Like, maybe it's a gated reverb or something, or a reverse gated reverb or something, or... So that's the dry sound. Oh. Ah, maybe just that. Damn, that's a big pedal to carry around for that one sound. I mean, it does other things as well, of course. And it's in the wrong part of the signal chain to use the octave. Ooh. That's the Frantabit. That's with a little delay, but... So I kind of want to be able to drop that in afterwards. Maybe get a loop going first. Maybe I can get a bit of a crazy sound happening. Oof. Wow, the mix is all the way up. I mean, I might be able to do it with the Frantabit. Now that's the Frantabit. Wow, those are some interesting sounds. Okay, I hadn't thought about doing it with the Frantabit and getting the synthy thing. Okay, so now I've got the delay happening. Let's go maybe. Maybe I want more of a note. That's a little crunchy though. Maybe I want to swell in. If my volume pedal wasn't full of cables. That's not bad. Something like that. I wonder if it's up. Maybe up the octave. Now I'm swelling in with the volume pedal. Okay, I've got that in the loop. Okay. Not the best loop, and I'm home, I'm not on a gig, I can redo that. This is the point of practicing, right? So, okay. Let's get it up the octave again, maybe. Maybe I want a little more aggressive with the delay, perhaps. There we go. I gotta get the loop pedal at the same time. I'm not used to using the loop pedal with my left foot so much. I I needed that. It's nice when it kind of comes together and you find new sounds. There were a bunch of percussive things in there. So glad that I am obviously making the vlog, but the byproduct of that being that I'm filming, recording. You know, I have the Zoom here, like, so I'm getting some high quality audio of this. Ooh, that's nice. Brain definitely feels a lot better. Doesn't take much. Really doesn't take much. That's a good thing. That's a very positive thing from this evening. It's late, 10:15 at night. Really what I want to do is crank all of this stuff up, like pile 3 more cabinets and make 10 times the amount of noise. But there's also the thing of becoming even more creative when you're limited. When you have fewer parameters to work with, you become way more creative with the ones that are available. And right now, the volume parameter is severely limited, but I'm still able to make music. So I am grateful for that. I will stop whining and moaning about living in an apartment. But in terms of making a move forwards, in terms of leaving behind what I've already done, I think that space and the ability to make large quantities of loud music is definitely going to be a massive key in moving forward. So I tell you what, I'll tell you what the pedals are right now, and I will list them below the signal chain. I'll give you the exact signal chain that I'm using. But just quickly, for those who want to know, in fact, you know what? I'll take the camera down here and show you what's going on. Okay, so very quickly, down here, I'm going into the volume pedal. I'm going into the volume pedal right there, which is going into the Miura, the M2 compressor, which is then going into the Moogerfooger Freq Box, the OC2, the PS5, the Frantabit, the Hall of Fame reverb, the TC Nova repeater, and then, of course, my trusty Ditto stereo. And finally, I'm into the Noble preamp, which then rolls over here into the amp and comes out of here. So that's the basic signal chain. The only reason that the Freq Box is so, it's up front so far in the signal chain is because I couldn't be bothered to repatch everything else and it was just an add-on. I wouldn't normally put something like that so close to the front. I'd like to have it after the octave pedal. So I'd like to have it after the OC2 and after the super shifter and probably somewhere in the same land as the ring modulators or the bit crushers or any of those kind of effects, like kind of in the middle of the board before I get to my subharmonic, my reverb, my delays, my looping, and eventually my little tube preamp, the Noble down here. So that's the geeky side of things, let you know exactly what's going on. I'll link to all the pedals in the description of the video below. But today's vlog is done, and I will see you guys tomorrow.